Hi, this is Matthew Kratter from Trader University, and today I want to talk about another way to make a lot of money in a financial crisis. This is part two, so if you missed part one, I'm going to put a link in the description notes below. Also, if you want to follow how I'm trading this bear market, and especially if you want to know when I think it's time to start buying stocks again, or when I'm going to start buying stocks again, be sure to hit that subscribe button. So let's get started. There's been a lot of talk about whether we're near a local bottom or not. One thing we can see is that the VIX is trading close today at 76. Now, the VIX is a measurement of fear, and it's driven by people buying puts on the S&P 500, which is a major stock index. And they're buying puts because puts are a form of insurance. But buying puts at this point is a little bit like buying flood insurance when your basement of your house is already filling up with water. So I'm going to show you a trade that is sort of the inverse of this. And that's a really nice way to sort of get back into the market, especially if you have some cash to play with. So go to Yahoo Finance and type in SPY up here, which is the ETF for the S&P 500. If you click on it, it will take you right here. And then you want to click on where it says options. And that will take you to this page. Now what we're going to do is we're going to go up here, and we're going to look at call and put options that are about 60 days out. So right now is March 18th, so we're going to look 2 months out. We're going to look at the May puts. So we want to select May here, and then you can see all the calls are right here. We're going to scroll down and look at the puts, which are right at the bottom here. Now these are the strike prices right here. We can see that the S&P closed today at a little bit more than 241 on the ETF. So we're going to want to be looking at the puts that are just out of the money. That means they have a strike price that's just below where the stock is trading right now. So SPY closed at 241 something, so we're going to be looking at the 241 puts. Now, this number right here, 27, is the last price that they traded at. Here's the bid. This is the price at which you can sell the puts, and the offer is $27.71. That's the price at which you can buy the puts. Now, if you're worried about a real stock market crash, and you're worried about a 1929 scenario, this is not a trade you want to do. And again, none of this is an investment recommendation. It's just a clever way of generating some cash flow in a bear market. It's something that Warren Buffett did in the previous financial crisis. He was actually selling puts on a railroad company that he ended up buying, which is really nice if you can sell puts on something and then buy it. That was Burlington Northern. So you can either buy puts on this, which is certainly, I think, a bad idea at this point, because when the VIX is this high, when the VIX is really high, puts are very expensive. Now, what I'm going to talk about in this video is selling cash-secured puts. Options are obviously risky, and you have to know what you're doing, but cash secured puts are one of the safest way of trading options. And the reason they're called cash secured puts is you will have cash in your account that you're ready to use to buy the stock or ETF if it gets put to you, if the put buyer puts the stock to you. So it's basically a way of buying a stock or an index or an ETF at a discount to where it's trading right now. So the way you do this, basically, if you want to sell one put, you will sell one put right to the bid here at $27.50. Market's closed right now, but during regular market hours, you sell to the bid. And then at expiration, if the stock is below, if the ETF, if S&P 500, SPY, is below 241, you will be forced to buy 100 shares of the stock at 241. I keep saying stock, but it's actually an ETF for an index for the S&P 500. Now, if this ETF is trading above 241, you just get to keep the cash. You get to keep the $27.50. Now, let's look a little bit how this works. So if this ETF gets put to you, you're going to need to have $24,100 in your account. Obviously, this is a fairly large size trade for many people. You can do this on individual stocks too, like Coke or McDonald's or something like that. But the key to this, and what makes it not risky, or a lot less risky, is that you have the cash ready to go into your account. And so the worst that happens is you end up owning this ETF, which is basically a basket. You know, it's basically the U.S. stock market, the largest cap companies. You own them at 241. You own 100 shares, and that's what will show up into your brokerage account if this ETF gets put to you. So you need to have that $24,100 ready to go. You can have less than that, which is, at that point, it becomes a little bit more gambling. You can have half of this, but then if the stock gets put to you, you're either going to be trading on margin, or you're going to have to wire some money into your account, or they're just going to liquidate your account. So the really conservative way to do cash secured puts, and by the way, cash secured puts are exactly the same as covered calls. They're because of put call parity. So the other way to do this is you could just buy the market right here at 241 and sell an at the money call, sell a 241 call. I like doing the puts because it's a little cleaner. Rather than having to buy the stock and then sell a call, you just sell the puts and it's just one transaction. And especially if you're paying commissions, which you probably shouldn't be at this point because you can be at Robinhood. But if you're paying commissions, it's better to just be selling puts rather than buying the stock and selling calls. So that's the starting point. You need to have this much money in your account, $24,100. Now, when you sell one put, when you sell the 241 puts, we saw that they're priced, basically the bid was $27.50. And you can try to sell somewhere halfway between the bid and ask when the market's open. So if it's $27.50 by $27.71, maybe you put in an order at $27.60. I wouldn't worry about that too much. I usually just hit the bid and give up that 20 cents if I just want to get the trade on, because it's not a huge difference. But basically, you'll be selling the put at $27.50. You'll sell one put. And because every put controls 100 shares, there's a multiplier associated with it. So if you sell one put at $27.50, you will collect in cash in your brokerage account $27.50 times 100, or $2,750. Now, if SPY is at or above 241 at expiration on, what did we say, May 15th, or whatever it was up here, you will get to keep this $27.50. It's just cash. It's cash in your account. It's sort of segregated until those options expire. You can't really wire it out or anything, but you'll get to keep this cash if SPY is trading at or above 241 at expiration. If SPY is trading below 241, and if it's below 241 at expiration, you will be forced to buy 100 shares of SPY 241, which isn't the worst thing in the world. This is what a lot of people do in their retirement accounts. They buy index funds. This is basically an index fund that you can hold for a very long time. And again, this is kind of a long-term trade. It might be over in 60 days, but if you get put that SPY, you got to be able to hold it, because you never know, market could fall more. But the nice thing about this is, because you are collecting $27.50 up front, your actual break-even point on the trade would be 241 minus $27.50. So that is 241 minus $27.50 is $213.50. That would be your break-even price on the SPY. So the market could fall another 11%, and you would still not have bought or lost any money. So this is essentially a sneaky way of buying the SPY, an index fund, about 11% below where it's trading. You can think of it that way. But if we rally from here, you'll just get to keep this $2,750, and the puts will expire worthless, and you will have made, how much will you have made? But we can say $27.50 divided by how much capital we risk, $24,100. And again, if the stock market goes to zero, the most you can lose on this trade is $24,100. I don't expect anything like that to happen. In fact, I think we're closer to a bottom than anything like that happening. So if we take $27.50 divided by $24,100, I did the same thing up here with just fewer zeros, you get 11.41%. So you're basically on this trade, assuming you think it's a good time to do it and your financial advisor does, you're making over almost 11.5% on your money in just 60 days. So if you were to annualize that, which, you know, might not happen, you can basically multiply that by 6. And so that's about a call it a 68% annualized return. Now, this is, as I said, this is a strategy that Warren Buffett has used in the past, selling index option puts or selling puts on individual stocks. But it's a really nice way to profit from a financial crisis and from a bear market, just simply because people are desperate for insurance. And what you're doing is you're basically selling them insurance, saying, you know, I'm not scared. I'm happy to own the 500 biggest U.S. stocks in a basket. You know, this includes Apple and Facebook and Coke and McDonald's and all these companies. And if, you know, one of these goes bankrupt, they'll just replace. You'll have 499 companies and they'll replace it with a new one. Some new tech company from Silicon Valley that's come public. So that's how you do cash secured puts. If you are interested in more strategies like this, I'd encourage you to check out my Bear Market Trading Strategies book on Kindle. I'm going to stick a link in the description notes below. And today and tomorrow, it's completely free. Costs $0 on Kindle, or you can buy the paperback for just $6.99. And this has lots more strategies that you can use to trade a bear market. If you found this video helpful, be sure to hit that subscribe button and that like button. If you have any questions about this, if you're not familiar with options, you can ask me in the notes below. I also have a bunch of courses. If you're stuck at home and you want to learn how to trade and really dig down and get good at the markets, I've got a bunch of courses on my site, Learn to Trade Stocks Like a Pro, Learn to Trade Options Like a Pro. And if you want to join, there are about 12 courses on here, Swing Trading with Options, Follow My Crypto Investments. There's also a whole course on bear market trading strategies. If this is something that interests you, I'm running a promotion right now. You just click join, and then you go down here and you click get it now. Now, normally monthly tuition access for 30 days is just $125. But I'm currently running a promotion for YouTube folks. If you just go down here and click YouTube, if you just click the coupon code and type in YT99, click update, and that will take $26 off. And that will give you 30 days access to every course. There are like 10, 11, 12 courses on the website, literally hours and hours and hours of courses. You can watch all the courses within 30 days and then cancel. There are no long-term contracts or anything. So if that's something, if you want to dig deeper, if you don't want to pay for things right now, if you're watching your cash, check out my books, free books on Amazon. The rest of my books are just $2.99. And then, of course, there's a whole YouTube channel, which has years and years of videos. So I try to make 99% of my material completely free, or just, you know, $2 or $3 on Kindle. And then for the 1% who really want to dig down and get good at this and learn how to generate income from home, especially, which is very nice, especially when you're trapped at home because of coronavirus, there are those courses there. So I hope you guys are all doing well, staying healthy, and surviving this really, really brutal bear market. Drop your questions in the comment sections below, and I'll see you in the next video. Thanks a lot for watching.